Hi, I'm Carol Misek LePage, class of 1971.
Hi, and I'm Eric LePage, class of 1974.
Okay. I grew up in Fall River in the South End and went to school at St. Patrick's Grammar School, although I was a Polish-French gal. Used to be in the Irish plays and do the Irish jig. And so then I moved on to Mount St. Mary Academy and graduated from there in 1969. Was in the Glee Club and, you know, various organizations.
I grew up in Fall River, down a Flint section of the city. Later on, moved over to the Brayton Avenue section, and then down to, afterwards, to the Bedford Street area up towards Eastern Avenue. I went to school at Diamond Regional. I was in the drafting department. I graduated from Diamond Regional in 1969 and started at BCC.
I found out about BCC because I lived in the community. I mean, it was just a very well-known community college with a great reputation. And I majored in secretarial science. Thought that's, you know, as I had been a secretary part-time while I was in school, high school, working at various hospitals, and thought that was the career I wanted to follow. After BCC, I worked for several years as a secretary at Family Service Association, in the courthouse, Superior Courthouse, in the clerk's office, and then in pretrial services. And while I was doing that, I also started taking some classes at SMU in the evening and decided that I really wanted to further my education with a marketing degree. So then I moved on full-time for another 2 years to SMU.
I was at BCC for a year, and I decided that I was going to get out and go into service at that point. I wanted to change majors. At that time, I was in the engineering department. And I figured, since I was going to change majors, I'd take a break. So I went to U.S. Navy. I did 2 years active. And then when I got out of the Navy, I went back to BCC. And I spent one more year there between summer classes and night classes. I finished up in 1 year and got my associates in business administration. After BCC, I went on to SMU. I majored in management. Basically, I took a lot of management courses, industrial relations courses. When I did graduate, I finished up with my degree in business management, but I also had a minor in industrial relations and in mathematics.
I met Eric at BCC, most likely in the cafeteria. That's where people would converse and, you know, gather. And we started dating, and the first date, I believe, was like on a road rally where you had to follow instructions and find items, and you ended up at a party at someone's house in Taunton. But that's how I met him, and we just hooked up, and that's it, 36 years later.
I worked about 40 to 60 hours a week besides going to school full time. Winter times, mostly offshore lobster. Well, later years offshore. When my first stint at BCC, I basically worked cooking at different little restaurants in the area. And then later on, after I got out of the service, I started lobstering offshore. Mm-hmm. And I would gill net codfish in the wintertime because it was good, real good money. So I was sometimes put in as much as 40 to 60 hours a week doing that, besides going to school full time.
Mm-hmm. And how'd you have time for
We always fit her in here and there. Well, LePage's got started because we did okay in the real estate market before when the boom hit. And we built ourselves another new house in Tiverton. And we had a few bucks extra, and I decided I wasn't working for anybody else anymore, so I started LePage's. We had opened up a Red's Dairy, 1,000 square feet. And what we had was, I had a fish market inside there, and we cooked behind the line, and we had 20 seats.
Paper plates, plastic forks, right. You know, it was very casual.
And we just blew them out of the water. What we did the first weekend in business, our projection for the first month. So it was a tough week. I mean, it was tough when we first started. I mean, we did well, we did extremely well, but it was we had growing pains real bad.
And the building went up for sale, and Red's Dairy was talking about buying it maybe with us, and we didn't want to be in partnership, and we didn't want to be a rentor anymore. So this building became available that we're in now, and Eric said, let's go for it. Let's, you know, we can have a lounge, we can be a full-service restaurant with alcohol, which we did not have at the other location. So it just seemed to make sense. I'd say it's been a roller coaster ride like anything else in life. It started to take off in the early years. There wasn't much competition in the area, you know, the whole surrounding area. And then, you know, the Applebee's, Pub 99's, oh, and in Dartmouth at the mall, all those restaurants opened. So now we were, you know, there's a lot of competition. And so that hurt. That hurt a bit. And, you know, you just, with my skills and Eric's skills, we just, and our tenacity, you know, what we learned at BCC and everywhere, you know, with our instructors, you just keep going. You just keep pushing. We have given back to the community, and BCC obviously being one of the organizations. We've given back to hospitals, all types of businesses in the area. We do a lot of fundraisers. We do, we work on-site or off-site. You know, we'll contribute food. I do a lot of the fundraisers and serve food. Narrow Center for the Arts has their event in September, always at that. As I said, South Coast Hospital, St. Anne's, BCC, I've been involved with them before. People Incorporated, Make-A-Wish, Facts and Animal Rescue League. So we give back to the community. You know, you can't just be here and not be involved, you know. And it's cool because we see people we went to college with and you know, community college as well. So it's a nice experience.